Hello guys, and welcome to a new crypto video of the most beautiful music instrument there is, the crypto violin. Guys, I hope you have an amazing day. I am back with some amazingly bullish content. I hope you're ready. I'm gonna show you the XRP BTC pair and I'm gonna explain you why I am extremely bullish on the breakout of XRP BTC pair. We got the breakout and the retest. We're gonna talk about this. We're gonna talk about the lawsuit developments, new developments, and very juicy news about the lawsuit. And I'm gonna give you my thoughts on when moon. So before we dive into the juicy bullish content, I want to kindly remind you to subscribe to the Beautiful Crypto Violin channel. Like if you like content provided and comment in the comment section. But without further ado, let's dive into the juicy bullish content air for you today. Okay guys, welcome to the video. Let's go look at the XRP BTC pair on the Bitstamp exchange. And if we look at the daily time frame, we see that XRP since August has been in a downtrend. Okay, so it has been 118 days of going down against the Bitcoin pair. And guys, oh, it's so annoying to wait for XRP, because XRP can just give us some bullishness and very good price action for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days, and then let us wait 118 days. And this is not fun. I don't like this. So I'm planning on contacting Brett Garlinghouse of this technical issue of the XRP token, or maybe David Schwartz. But there is something that annoys me here. The previous time XRP exploded, that was like a 45-day time where the prices moved. But even there, you see that in 2 days it moves, and then 4 days of sideways trading, then 1, 2, 3 days of explosion, and then again a big dip. So this is always the case. So when XRP explodes, keep this in mind guys, keep the following in mind, that XRP moves very fast, it will rise very hard, but then again after 1 or 2 weeks the move will be over. For example, during December 2017, XRP price exploded against the Bitcoin pair, astonishing 1730%, so almost 18x, so more than 18x in a period of 29 days. And afterwards the XRP price, it went down for 257 days, and then it moved 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days up, and then again down and sideways for a period of 653 days. So take profit where you can when Godzilla awakes, because afterwards it will go back to sleep. And you don't want to hold XRP while it's sleeping, because you know what? It has given me so much gray hairs, it's not funny. Okay? So what do I expect to happen here? Well guys, if we look very closely, we got a breakout on December the 9th. And that's yesterday. And then today we got a beautiful retest. And everybody say, yeah, you tweeted breakout and nothing happened, and you posted the buy signal and nothing happened. Yeah, well guys, should I say something? The previous time XRP against the Bitcoin pair broke out, it retested again. And after the retest, it had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, then it had 10 days of sideways trading, and then it exploded beautiful 355% to 355%. If we can manage to do the 355%, then 8,500 sats is a pretty good level to watch for. Okay, if we look at the XRP USD pair at the moment, we are currently in a downward trend, and we need to break the downward trend and go again to an upward trend, because I don't like this. Well, I know for a fact that you all are waiting and looking at XRP. You know, I watched the market today so much that I have a headache and I am actually tired. I am ready for this coin to explode. And you know what? I have to share something with you, because I am only buying XRP at this moment, no other coins. And if you ask me why, I will tell you, because XRP has the biggest upside potential and is just suppressed. it's a suppressed asset, and I don't want to buy Ethereum or Bitcoin that are already 50x'd from bear market lows. No, I want to buy the suppressed asset that didn't explode to new all-time highs yet. But I will tell you this, guys, even if XRP hits $10 in the next 2 weeks, it was not worth it. This crypto was not worth it because it lagged so much. It was a laggard and it consumed our times so much. We could make so much money outside of this crypto and then re-enter the position of XRP. But no, XRP decided to test our patience. But one thing I can be extremely sure about, and that is that I am not going anywhere. I waited for 4 years and I will wait another, no, I will not wait another 4 years. No, I will not wait another 4 years, but I will wait this out, because this settlement, it can happen any moment, or Ripple wins the lawsuit. Either way, it will be settled any moment to maybe 4 months from now, but then it's gone. And I think it can happen any moment, but there is so much upside potential. XRP is suppressed right now. That's the perfect time to buy. And guys, historically, if we go back, we see, let me go and just show you the weekly chart here. Look, guys, this is 2013, the month December. A 10x happened here against the USD pair, the XRP USD pair. Then November 2014, let me show you the price action, 565, so explosion of 6x. Then November 2015, we got a 125% price rise. Then a juicy run in February, March, okay, very nice. But then here, the 11th of December 2017, the price of XRP exploded almost 15x. That's crazy, guys. So we have 2017 in December, we have 2015 in November, we have 2014 December, we have 2013 November. So guys, I want to explain you the following. November and December are very interesting months. So I am not feeling down in this month. This is the month where it should happen. Okay, I'm extremely bullish this month. And you know, right now in the month November, we only went down 51%. So it's not possible. If we go back and look at what XRP has done in the previous years, it's not possible that December will be closed with a loss, because November or December is a minimum of 150% to a maximum of 1400% price action for XRP in the previous years. So I am not feeling down right at this moment. I know we can skyrocket. If you go back to 2017, we see here that the 10th of December 2017 was, let me check what it was. It was a Sunday. So beautiful Sunday, and then Monday we got a little bit of price action, and then Tuesday we skyrocketed out of here. Okay, in the weekend I don't expect a major bull run to start. No, I don't. But the coming Monday or the coming week will be very interesting, guys. Mark my words, next week will be interesting. So please don't feel down. I hope the bullishness is entering your veins and your system, because don't feel down. I know it's hard, and what is happening at the SEC, it's corrupt and it's dirty and it's not fun to watch, because it's just one puppet show. I know, everybody knows it. And the SEC got sued. This was tweeted by Crypto Law, and I wanted to cover this for you. Watchdog group sues SEC for Clayton Hinman records. Agency won't comply with the FOIA request from August. Empower underscore US ask judge to force compliance. Okay, so Empower Oversight sues SEC for access to FOIA documents amid crypto conflict of interest concerns. Empower Oversight filed a lawsuit against the Securities and Exchange Commission seeking to compel the SEC to comply with several Freedom of Information Act requests regarding potential conflict of interest by former high-level officials and their regulation of cryptocurrencies. In August, Empower Oversight submitted a detailed FOIA request of the SEC seeking any communications related to senior SEC officials and their current and former employers regarding cryptocurrencies. Former senior SEC official William Hinman received millions of dollars in compensations from his former employer, Simpson Treacher, while helping guide the SEC's regulation of cryptocurrencies. Simpson Treacher is part of a group that promotes Enterprise Ethereum, a cryptocurrency. Hinman said that Ethereum wasn't a security, which in turn caused a spike in its value. The creator of another cryptocurrency known as XRP was later sued by the SEC, which claimed that it was a security, causing XRP to lose a quarter of its value. The man who brought the lawsuit against XRP, Mark Berkner, left for Simpson Treacher shortly after Hinman did the same. Finally, former SEC Chairman Jay Clayton may have had conflicts of interest when he declared that Bitcoin was not a security. After his time at the SEC, Clayton joined a cryptocurrency hedge fund, One River Asset Management, that only worked on Bitcoin and Ether. To date, the SEC has failed to comply with 6 of the 8 categories of documents in Empower Oversight FOIA requests. The SEC claimed that searches of 2 of the 8 categories yielded no records relating to communications between Mr. Clayton or Mr. Berger and the SEC's Office of Ethic Counsel regarding their future employers and any potential recusals. The other 6 requests remain entirely unanswered. Wow, so 8 requests, 2 of them they say no, we don't have anything, and the other 6 they don't even answer. Who are those bitches working for? I don't understand this. Securities and Exchange Commission is there to protect investors, to serve the United States citizens. But no, it's just a mafia. It's like out of a movie. It's crazy. And you know what? I don't feel good to talk about the lawsuit anymore because it's just one big joke. And we can just wait until this thing gets settled. But if the SEC continues to act so irresponsible and work against all the interest of the ordinary investor, well, you know what? I think Ripple will say, you know what? We will bury you. The only way SEC lawyers will leave the court is in a body bag. And I think they will drag this lawsuit. Ripple will drag this lawsuit till the end. And they will completely destroy the SEC. And the SEC will beg Ripple. And then maybe the SEC will have to pay all the lawyers, everything, and all the expenses that Ripple made. And you know what? That's being paid out of tax money. So it's crazy. This is so bad, guys. Well, I am extremely happy for XRP and what XRP will bring us regarding price action in December. I hope I made you bullish enough. Please don't be scared. Don't be sad. We will make it. We are the XRP army. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next juicy and bullish video. Have an amazing day. Bye-bye.